Most people believe that there is one way that the body responds to stress. You know, everyone's heard the fight or flight response, but it actually turns out that that's just one way that the body and brain can respond to a stressful circumstance. And it's often not a very helpful way to respond to a stressful circumstance, especially one in which you really want to rise to the challenge and perform your best, where it's really not about survival mode. And it turns out that the brain and the body actually has another way of responding to these kind of high-stakes challenges, you know, whether it's an important negotiation, or you have to give a speech, or an athletic competition, those moments where you really want to show up and do your best. And that other way of responding to stress is called a challenge response, that it's a way for your brain and body to give you maximum focus, attention, and energy. And it's physically different than the sort of the fight or flight response that we have when we feel deeply threatened by a stressful situation. When you have a threat response, you know, your body and brain are shifting into the state that is really the sort of the classic association with the harmful stress response. It's going to make you more likely to choke under pressure. It's going to feel more like dread or overwhelm. When you have a challenge response, the brain and body actually shift into a state that gives you more access to your resources. You know, your heart might still be pounding, but your blood vessels are going to relax and open up so you get more blood flow to your muscles and to your brain. Your brain shifts into a state that's actually better at paying attention to everything in your environment rather than sort of being laser focused like you might be in a fight or flight response on what's going wrong or what's, you know, what's dangerous. When you have a challenge response, all of your senses open to all the information that's available to you, which means you're basically smarter under stress. And researchers have gotten really interested in figuring out how do you get people to shift from a threat response into a challenge response, because unless your life is on the line in some sort of crazy emergency situation, it's going to be better for you to have a challenge response than a threat response. You'll perform better, and that's been shown in situations ranging from people performing surgery, to athletes on the field, to students taking difficult exams, that when you have a challenge response, you just do better. And it seems like one of the best ways to shift from a threat response to a challenge response is actually to view your own stress response as a resource. You know, the reason that many people have a threat response in a stressful situation is that the very first signs of anxiety, when they notice some sweat on their brow or they're starting to feel their heart pound, they think, uh-oh, I'm about to blow it. And they turn their attention to trying to calm down or trying to suppress whatever stress is arising. And research originally coming out of Harvard University has shown that when people say, okay, I'm stressed out, I feel stress happening right now, and that's a resource, that stress can actually help me do better, it actually changes the physiology of the stress response from threat to challenge, and it helps people perform better, whether they're giving a talk in public, whether they are engaging in a business negotiation, whether they're a student taking an exam. Across many scenarios, literally just embracing your own stress, energy, arousal, or anxiety can transform what's happening in your brain and body to really help you rise to the challenge.